General Dynamics Bath Iron Works has officially christened the USS Louis H. Wilson DDG-126, the U.S. Navy's newest Flight III Arleigh Burke class destroyer. This marks the shipyard's very first Flight III build. The ship is named after General Louis H. Wilson, Jr., a Marine Corps legend, Medal of Honor recipient, and former Commandant of the Marine Corps. His legacy of courage and leadership was highlighted throughout the ceremony. Around 1,500 people attended the event, including shipbuilders, families, and guests. Maine Governor Janet Mills and Senator Angus King both gave speeches honoring the ship and its namesake. Bath Iron Works President Charles F. Krugh told the audience that General Wilson's bravery and long service continue to inspire the shipbuilders who brought DDG-126 to life and are now preparing it for delivery to the Navy. The destroyer is expected to set sail in the coming weeks. Meanwhile, Bath Iron Works has several other Arleigh Burke class destroyers currently under construction, ensuring the Navy's fleet continues to grow. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Flight III Arleigh Burke destroyer USS Louis H. Wilson is an especially impressive warship. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Arleigh Burke class destroyers are named after Admiral Arleigh Burke, a legendary World War II destroyer commander who later became Chief of Naval Operations. These warships are designed for multi-mission roles, capable of handling anti-air, anti-submarine, and anti-surface warfare. The newest upgrade, known as Flight III, is the fourth major evolution of the class in over 30 years. It follows Flight I, II, and IIA. While the ships keep the same proven hull design, Flight III brings powerful new systems. The biggest change is the AN-SPY-6, Air and Missile Defense Radar, the Navy's next-generation radar. It greatly improves the ship's ability to detect and track advanced aircraft and missile threats. Flight III destroyers also feature Lockheed Martin's Aegis Baseline 10 combat system, which integrates all the ship's weapons for faster reactions and better readiness. To support these upgrades, the ships have improved power and cooling systems. The AN-SPY-6 is the U.S. Navy's next-generation radar, an active electronically scanned array, or AESA 3D radar. It's designed to give ships integrated air and missile defense, and it will be first deployed on Flight III Arleigh Burke class destroyers. Variants of the radar are also being built for Flight IIA destroyers, Constellation-class frigates, Ford-class aircraft carriers, and San Antonio-class amphibious ships. SPY-6 radars are fully integrated with the Aegis combat system, allowing them to defend against ballistic missiles, cruise missiles, hostile aircraft, and even surface ships, all at the same time. Compared to older radars, SPY-6 offers far greater detection range, higher sensitivity, and much better target discrimination. This means that weapons like the SM-6 missile can intercept incoming threats more reliably. One of the biggest strengths of SPY-6 is its scalable modular design. The radar is built from units called Radar Modular Assemblies, RMA, which can be grouped together to meet the needs of different classes of ships. This approach lowers costs and makes upgrades and maintenance easier across the fleet. The system itself consists of two primary radars and a radar suite controller. The S-band radar handles long-range volume search, ballistic missile tracking, and communications. The X-band radar provides precision tracking, horizon search, and terminal target illumination. Together, they also support navigation, periscope detection, and missile guidance. SPY-6 uses gallium nitride GaN semiconductors, which allow much higher power density compared to older gallium arsenide modules. As a result, the radar needs roughly twice the electrical power of its predecessor, but it generates over 35 times more radar power. While it wasn't originally designed for electronic attack, The AESA antenna may give it that capability in the future. For the Arleigh Burke class, two variants are deployed, Inspy 6V1, also known as the Air and Missile Defense Radar, with four phased array faces, each containing 37 RMA. It offers up to 15 decibels more sensitivity than the older SPY-1 radar, meaning it can detect targets half the size at double the distance. This version is built for Flight III destroyers. ANSPY 6V4, a smaller version with 24 RMA per array. It's designed to retrofit Flight IIA destroyers, bringing them a major leap in capability without a full rebuild. With its advanced design, raw power, and scalability, the ANSPY 6 will serve as the U.S. Navy's primary radar for decades, protecting the fleet against the most advanced threats. The Aegis Weapon System Baseline 10 is the newest and most advanced version of the U.S. Navy's combat system software. Built on a completely new architecture, it's designed to bring upgrades and new capabilities to the fleet much faster than ever before. According to Lockheed Martin, this modernized design will dramatically shorten the time needed to deliver new features, cutting development cycles from several months down to just a few weeks. Baseline 10 works hand-in-hand with the Common Source Library, or CSL, a unified software repository that combines all surface Navy combat capabilities into a single framework. This allows developers to quickly integrate and share updates across multiple ship classes, rather than building them separately for each platform. The new system is also supported by increasingly automated testing, which helps verify updates and push them to the fleet faster, with fewer errors. Lockheed Martin describes Baseline 10 as the most comprehensive evolution of the Aegis combat system to date, bringing more speed, agility, and adaptability to U.S. Navy warships. The USS Louis H. Wilson will enter service with one of the most extensive weapons packages in the U.S. Navy. At the heart of its firepower is the Mark 41 vertical launch system, with 96 missile cells arranged in two blocks of 32 and 64. These cells can launch a wide variety of weapons, including Tomahawk cruise missiles, Standard Missiles 2, 3, and 6, ESSM Block 1 and 2, and the RUM-139 AVL ASROC for anti-submarine warfare. The ship will also feature two Mark 141 Harpoon missile launchers for the anti-ship role, along with two triple torpedo tubes capable of firing Mark 46 or Mark 50 torpedoes against submarines. Tying all of these weapons together is the powerful pairing of the ANSPY 6V1 and the Aegis Baseline 10 combat system. This combination allows the destroyer to track threats at longer ranges, guide weapons with greater precision, and respond faster than ever before. With its advanced sensors and formidable arsenal, the USS Louis H. Wilson will stand among the most capable and versatile warships in the entire U.S. Navy fleet.